So we're out here fishing on one of our secret spots that we always go to, always get after them fish pretty well here. Oh, nothing there. We got the Markham out, and same with the Vexlar here. We got a nice little setup that we're going here. Trying to hit them panfish early in the season. About 8 inches of ice that we're sitting on right now, so should be a pretty good day. We'll tune in later and let us know how you do.
Oh, Sam's hooked up.
Ooh, feels decent. He's a fighter.
Oh, how's he look? No. Small?
Not big, but he's not small. You got him?
Yeah, I got one, folks. Zero fight to this puppy.
He's a smaller one.
He is a smaller one, I agree.
Come on, let's double this baby up.
Just a little one here. My bobber is about halfway down my hole. I'm going to set the hook. And of course I catch him. We don't miss fish in this hole. This is guaranteed fish. And I'm going to grab him. That's what we're dealing with, these guys.
I'm struggling here. Beautiful. Dang, he's good size, actually.
What'd you say, he's about 10?
Yeah, I'd give him a solid 10, maybe even like a 9.5 if we want a short ball. He's a good size fish, though.
It's going to release on him. Nice. Got him.
See you.
What do you think we got here, folks?
Another crop?
They're getting smaller. They're getting smaller, that's for sure.
Until we catch this giant that's on my screen.
Little crappie. 5-6 inches. I'm down the hole. There he goes.
How do you know what you're looking at?
You're facing it at you right now.
That's annoying. Oh, God, turd alert.
Turd alert is right. Look at this tiny thing.
We're having chicken nuggets for dinner tonight. More like fish nuggets. Gone as the wind blows. Back up in Kentucky. All I want to do is drink beer in Kentucky, where the wind blows. And we talk like our tongues are stuck to the roof of our mouths. Please.
Fish on over here. Sam got a nice one. Just flies through the hole. What'd you get, Sam?
Oh, you know, a good little crop.
Hold him up, let him see.
This right here is hard work and dedication to the sport of ice fishing. Sometimes you go through your lulls. Sometimes you gotta miss fish in order to get the big ones. You know, this right here, this was a slump buster. Straight up slump buster.
What'd you use to get him?
Oh, a little horizontal Gens worm right here. Definitely a very good choice.
Very nice.
Slump buster. Hooked up and ready to play. What can we say? Ow. I got water in my eye. What a boy. What kind of fish is that, Nick?
Looks to me like a crappie.
You want to guesstimate a length on him?
8 inches.
8 inches?
Yeah, jeez. 7? 8?
Yeah, little he's guy. A good sized fish. Keeper? No, we're sportsmen's here at Sportsman's Lodge and Clam Outfitters.
Well guys, tonight we're just using this little Gens worm with a little minnow head. Sam, I'm trying to do what I'm using.
What the? good fish here. You know, nothing but talent coming from this end of the ice house. He's a small one, but, you know, sometimes if you catch the small ones, the big ones will come in a little bit later because they eat the small ones. You know what I'm saying. That's how this life of fishing goes. Well, sometimes you win some in fishing and sometimes you don't. Other times you just have giant snags. Oh, look at that. Can't get any more lucky than that. It's like I'm stealing somebody's Cheerios or whatever that Lucky Charm. Lucky Charms! There it is. Well, moral of the story was I was lounging around in our nice little cozy ice house here. And I was just jigging away, not paying attention. And I have no idea how long this fish has been on. It's a decent little, maybe 6 to 7 inch crappie here, but I mean it's been a slower night, but not too slow. We've been catching fish, but yeah, I have no idea how long this fish has been on. Let's release him so he can make some more children for us. Like a charm, swimming away in beautiful.
But, yeah. How much money you got? How much money you got?